Nothing much. You're just happy. Yeah, we are still number one on Netflix.
How you guys are taking it all, the response, the feedback that you guys are getting.
I think that has to be the most honest answer कि आरती ने अभी जो बोला कि that is exactly how we are right now. We are just कि हमने जो भी करना था, इतने सालों की मेहनत, इतने टाइम का जो भी पुश किया, रिलीज कराया, दैट नाउ इज द टाइम वेयर वी आर सिटिंग बैक एंड एंजॉयिंग द लव दैट इज कमिंग आवर वे.
Right. Sci-fi is definitely not something that is like a regular jazz for Indian cinegoer audience, like who are like hardcore Hindi film देखने वाले लोग, ठीक है? तो उस हिसाब से a very different kind of a this is not meant for Indian audience kind of a jazz that you are getting into, and that's why it was challenging. Because I can see like there are
Actually,
so friend of yours kind of contributed I mean, there are so many industry people who contributed into that, whether it's Vikram Motwani, whether it's Anurag Kashyap, whether it's there's this lyricist, writer, and all these people, Hansen Mehta, and yeah, I mean, almost as he can, a half of the industry is there. So
फिल्म आई थिंक माई सेंसिबिलिटी आई एक्चुअली सी माई सेल्फ एज एन ऑडियंस लाइक आई थिंक दैट्स अ लर्निंग आई हैव लर्न फ्रॉम लॉट ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स Right from like the top biggest directors outside India, but even in directors in India, Rajkumar Hirani, whose work I always follow because their work actually do so well. And he always says that think of yourself as an audience, and then write it because that will be an honest film. And then like then of course like because and for me this was at least the case. And I also have come to realize that my exposure is little different of sci-fi. My exposure of philosophy is little different. So that's why so many times a lot of people have said, "Oh, you've just done a touch and go for a lot of concepts," like But now I feel that yeah, I mean, I need to be also see myself also with that lens, like that maybe I have read so much of this book and that's why I'm saying it and I'm feeling this is enough because. There's a very good feedback someone gave me, and he said, "Your film is like reading a good book, like that you have given me a lot, but you have left enough for my imagination to piece together things." So yeah, so but when I was writing it, I was writing it with as much honesty as possible, which I want to continue to do that. Like I don't want to be any time dishonest because I've seen you the best, like best of filmmakers, becoming too conscious of the audience and becoming dishonest. But at the same time, I know that like. I have to also improve. Like, this is my first film, first time this has happened that I've received so much feedback. So I want to respect that feedback also. I want to assimilate and, grow. So that is also there. And then even otherwise, I want to keep growing in terms of stories I make and all that. Yeah. So, but the idea is always that you should, I mean, I make it honestly for myself, like, as an audience, but as an audience who's detached from myself, because I try to see that is the emotion flow is falling, but at least. But maybe sometimes it's working more for me than others. That is always there. That I also have to figure out. But like, yeah, I always see myself as an audience and I as a detached audience when I'm watching a film. Like how instinctively the film is affecting me. That I see like that.
Right. Now, Shweta and Aarti, I have to ask. There are two very important things that I want to touch upon in this interview. One of them is as we were like the other day when we were chatting, she was saying that she has a baby, Aarti has a baby, and handling that, on one side there's this motherhood and all that, and on the other hand, this is a film where I mean, if gives us the glimpse of a different world altogether. I so can imagine how she was imaginative, right? Doing all that. You, on the other hand, Shweta, I have seen no change in you. Even after your marriage, so-called that people still believe that after marriage things just change for girls especially. you still look 16. You, I think for coming 5 years also, you can be part of teenage love story. So, good genes, no? So tell me, do you think with more and more girls are continuing their career, the way they, their ambition, the way they are continuously doing it, do you think somewhere you guys are off camera also changing the narrative of women, especially those stereotype of like, you know, after marriage you cannot do this, or after baby you cannot do that? Because I so can see you two girls are like the example of that. So tell me.
Wow.
So first thing I want to say is one of the also reasons why Shweta looks so fresh, and because, you know, it's also the beauty radiates inside out. I think her heart is genuinely very pure, and she's a very giving person, and also it's also mature heart. Like, so if she sees negativity, she can take it and she handles it very nicely. So she's just pure light. Like, I think that's the reason her face glows. Like, you know, it's that beauty.
And
it
is like the best hug that I know.
So I think that's the secret of Shweta. So like, I think even the skin doctor said that you should be healthy inside. So I think she's like, you know, not just like in terms of that, but her mind is so pure that, you know, she continues to look so pure and beautiful. Like, you know, so I think that's one of the things. And as what you said about changing the narratives, I think, yeah, I like first starting from Shweta's character herself, like, you know, space travel has been such an immense domain, like science, technology, what you call a STEM, that has been such a male's domain. And our film, we have a female astronaut, she's talking, and we were very careful that she's not just an eager beaver when she joins. She is questioning her superior, she is putting her foot down, and she, at the same time, she's compassionate enough to feel what she wants to feel. So, you know, we are creating role models for women. So we are not creating that women has to just do, you know, boxing to, you know, be equal in this world. Yeah, exactly. So she is a compassionate self. She's a healer. The strengths of a woman. And still, she's a woman of substance. So I think that in itself, I think it's a very lovely role model Shweta is as a, this thing. I feel that. Yeah, and there, I mean, I think for me also, like, if the more women directors, like Shweta says in so many interviews, you can count women directors and fingers. People say, oh, yeah, we are equal. But then why there are like thousands, like hundreds of, not hundreds, but like still quite a few male directors and few female. So every female director at today's age will, you know, contribute to the change in landscape. So each of us is very important, like, you know, whether it's me or anyone else. And I also try to really encourage a lot of
people. I understand. Yes, I understand that. But, you know, many times it also happens that, you know, women especially, even though they used to be ambitious otherwise, what happened that once motherhood happened, it's like, you know, I want to, like, you know, enough is enough or stuff like that. But in your case, that's not the thing. That is what I'm admiring. Like, you know, the fact that, you know, like, you know, that is one part of it, but this is also what I love. So how emotionally, and what I was trying to figure out is that how emotionally, because, you know, if you are married and if you have a happy marriage life, you love that, but you also love your professional life. If you love your motherhood, like, so how you manage that or compartmentalize everything emotionally?
Yeah. I think, you know, what this has happened to me is I've learned to become very good multitasker in a way after a child, like, you know. So, I mean, not to say that, like, I really love my daughter passionately. And when I'm with her, I completely forget my work. Well, it's that much of a vacuum type thing. But when I'm at work, like, there are hours I forget about her. Like, I'm so involved. So, of course, you need to, one of the things is to build a support system for yourself that you can afford to do that. But still, there was time, like, you know, I think during the shoot also, once my daughter was having fever. So there are times that, like, I've told them that don't shield me from bad news. Like, oh, she's working, so we should not disturb her. So there were times I was coordinating that also, okay, talking to doctor, what is happening. But that you have to take it into stride. I think, you know, having a child has made me so focused with my work. I cannot tell you. Like, otherwise, I used to waste my time a lot. And now I only just spend time with my daughter, and it helps me, like, in my work. Like, things, like the kind of, and especially the things that she's introduced me with, like right from unicorns to so many things, like, you know, she's widening my exposure in a very big way.
Said that your mother-in-law is probably the biggest fan in the house.
Yeah.
Tell me more.
Through my characters, somewhere I try to say what I believe in as well. So, for example, in Gone Kesh, I really did not think I looked any lesser. I looked any less cute or whatever it is when I didn't have hair. And obviously, it's easier for me to do it because I know I'm doing it for a role. And when somebody is going through that condition, it's a very sensitive place to be in. And aapko hamesha hi lagega ki mere saath aisa kyun ho raha hai. कि हर किसी को चाहे आप यू नो कोई भी आपको व्हेन यू हैव अ लो टाइम और अ फ्रस्ट्रेटिंग पीरियड ऑफ लेट्स से मेबी समथिंग बट यू आर नॉट अलोन इन दिस इज व्हाट आई वुड लाइक टू टेल एवरीबॉडी एंड व्हाट यू वर आस्किंग आरती एंड आई थिंक इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर गर्ल्स टू नो इवन बॉयज दैट योर जेंडर डज नॉट डिफाइन योर ड्रीम्स नीदर डज योर एज नॉर डज योर रिलीजन नो These are things you're born into. And for example, agar alopecia bhi hai, this is a condition which is there. You can fight it, but you can also accept it. Obviously, it's difficult. I'm not saying it's easy at all. Wo bahut mushkil hoga. Kyunki society mein, industry mein, aapke neighborhood mein, there will be a lot of people who will try to bring you down or who will remind you.
As they do.
Yeah, they will keep reminding you of things which are not enough. But there are very few people who will remind you of things which are fabulous about you. So I think you should focus more on the positives. Negative sab mein hai, struggle sab ki hogi. As a mother, hats off to Aarti because it's not easy. And you have to celebrate the mothers in the industry, the wives in the industry, the daughters, sisters, everybody in the industry because there is this pressure of sorts jo ki men pe bhi hota hai. For example, to be the breadwinner of the family, that's also a pressure. So, aisa nahi hai ki zyada kam, but ye jo society ka pressure hota hai, it's as aapko lena hai to lo, lekin it's totally upon you. Matlab mujhse bhi bahut logon ne bola tha ki now that you're getting married, aapka career effect hoga, but I knew ki career effect kyun? Nobody is expecting me to change anything because they know how much I love my job. And if you are sure about that, and if you're vocal about that, and if you radiate that, people who love you and care for you, they will also understand that.
Correct. Correct. My last question that, you know, because in last 3 months, there are a lot of narratives, which is like horrendous in a way, especially what happens that people like us who are not from Mumbai, I mean, at least I'm talking about myself, like I'm not from Mumbai. Yeah. So क्या होता है कि जब बाहर से आने वाले लोग जब यहाँ पे आके अपना जगह बनाते हैं उसके बाद जब इस किस्म की वाहियात बहुत सारी नेगेटिव स्टोरी some of them are reality, some of them are not. I'm not getting into that, but such narratives definitely affects our parents and our friends and families. Okay. It does happen. So what do you guys want to say about it? And does that affect you? Like when you get to hear that 99% of the film industry people are drug addict, or, you know, like casting couch is the normal thing, or nepotism is a common practice, like, you know, depression is the common thing happens in the Tinseltown also because the dark side of the Bollywood industry is so darker, just opposite of the glitz and glamour that you get to see. How you guys are kind of, you know, going to react to that, and if that affected you guys at all?
Yeah, so I'm also an outsider, actually. So I completely understand that question because my extended family asked that question to my parents. But thankfully, my parents are so much around me. They say, ki pata nahi which Bollywood, because, you know, the thing what we do is like very normal, yeah. Like, and I have friends from within the Bollywood, and I have a lot of respect. And I've had like, you know, mother friends. Like, I know, like, for example, I know Kiran Rao, who has a son, and she's so dedicated and she's so in love with her son. I meet her in birthday parties, actually, you know, helping her son do this, and she's as normal as a person can be. So I don't know. Actually, the dark side, maybe it makes a lovely story that, you know, because there's this bliss, but that's the price you pay. Like, you know, it's a lovely story, but like, you know, I think the world is more or less gray in general. It's never like, even the glitz is not like very temporary, and even this is whatever. Like, of course, we also have challenges in our profession that every profession has. It's like, you know, and I can say that because I've been across two professions. I've been through engineering and going through the whole, you know, getting the admission, the whole, the campus placement, that is another tension altogether. So that also has its own, like, you know, challenges. So every industry has it. I don't know why they try to say that it's so, I haven't seen, I generally haven't seen. But I also like a person who sleeps at 10 o'clock. So my friends say also that, do you turn into a werewolf because we never seen you at 12 o'clock, you know? Maybe you turn into something in the night, like, you know? But like, we are, everybody's normal, yeah? We see this as a very job and a very huge responsibility and a privilege that we can create work that can potentially reach so many people. And it's also a luxury. Making a filmmaking is a luxury. Like, you know, we are like not fighting for survival, but we are actually creating what we want to create. So yeah, I mean, I think it's the raw. I don't know. I'm sure there might be something, but I don't know. It has eluded me. I haven't seen. Everybody I know is super middle class and super, like, you know, working hard and worried about their film, making sure. I know I once walked into Vikram's room when he was shooting for Trapped. And he's like, you know, this, and he's doing short breakdown. He's just writing it with so much hard work. Yaar, ye kaise karenge, ek hi location. So I saw that. So it's not that like they are just parting their way through this. Like, people are actually working very hard, you know, till their film is made.
I think exactly what Aarti said, ki it makes for a great story. Aapko lag raha hai ki pata nahi Bollywood ek aisi khufiya cave hai jahan pe andar pata nahi kya kya hota hai. So I just want to tell all the parents. कोई हमारा मुंह खोल के हमारे मुंह में ड्रग्स नहीं डाल रहा है। अगर आपके बच्चे को करना है तो वो किसी छोटे से शहर में के भी कर सकता है और वो बॉम्बे जैसी जगह में भी आके कर सकता है। एवरीबडी लेट्स होप कि हमारी जो आपने अपने बच्चों को ब्रिंगिंग दी है, आपने जो उनको वैल्यूज दिया है, आई थिंक द ओनली थिंग टू होप फॉर इज दैट देयर मॉरल कंपास इज पॉइंटिंग इन द राइट डायरेक्शन। वो सबसे ज्यादा जरूरी है। और दूसरी जरूरी है उनकी मेंटल हेल्थ। तो अगर आपको आई डोंट थिंक ड्रग्स से प्रॉब्लम होनी चाहिए कि आपका बच्चा ड्रग्स कर रहा है कि नहीं, आपको ये होना चाहिए कि आपका बच्चा ठीक है कि नहीं। तो रीच आउट और बार बार ये मत पूछे कि क्या हो रहा है, कितना पैसा है, बिकॉज दैट इज एन यू नो अन एडेड प्रेशर। आपके बच्चों को भी पता है कि पैसे कमाना जरूरी है, काम जरूरी है। एंड ट्रस्ट मी, बॉम्बे ऐसा शहर है कि एक व्हाट आई लव अबाउट बॉम्बे इज कि एवरीबडी वॉन्ट्स टू मेक इट। चाहे वो मेरी बिल्डिंग का वॉचमैन क्यों ना हो, चाहे वो एक लाइटमैन क्यों ना हो सेट पे, Everybody knows why they are here. कोई बॉम्बे नहीं आता है फैफ करने, कोई बॉम्बे नहीं आता है मजे करने। Yes, मजे आएंगे if you meet the kind of people and you do the kind right kind of work. हमें बहुत मजे आते हैं when we are working. But your priorities need to be set. So please don't worry. अगर there are people, if there is this, let's say a dark side, there is also the super positive side which Aarti and I have been very lucky to be in touch with. We have worked with people who don't only support us, but they also motivate and inspire us. So It's literally what you expose yourself to. So, अगर आपके बुरे experiences हुए भी हैं, तो वो it's life. Again, I'm saying it's not easy. When you're following your dreams, it's never easy, and there will be roadblocks and there will be certain hiccups. But it's your choice. अगर वो सिगरेट भी अगर आपके हाथ में है, तो आप वो smoke कर रहे हो, फेंक देते हो, वो आपके ऊपर है, कोई judge नहीं करेगा। अगर आपको पीनी है, तो आपको पियो, नहीं पीनी है मत पियो। There is no judging. But be true to who you are and be true to yourself. And be as open and supportive. Baki everything will fall into place. My parents, they are, I know ki agar mujhe kuch bhi problem hai, so I can get in touch with them. Also, I know that Aarti and I have been blessed with supportive families. Kahi jaga aapko wo support nahi milta. But it's very important to have a circle around you, chahe wo friends ka ho ya work logo ka ho, jinke saath aap cheeze discuss kar sakte ho. If you are going through a phase which is not easy, discuss that. Alcohol, drugs, cigarettes, these things might be a temporary solution, but it's never a permanent solution. So I think there is a bigger thing which needs to be addressed. Drugs, these are bahut upar, you know, ek layer hai. Wo main problem niche hai ki poocho ki us drug lene ki zarurat kyun pad rahi hai, daru peene ki zarurat kyun pad rahi hai. So, and anything, anyway, I don't want to say wrong things kyunki wo phir अलग मोड़ के बोल दी जाएंगी।
but I understood what you mean and you were so right that you know this is how it should be like, you know,
alcohol is not the problem. Alcohol is not the problem. Having alcohol every day, the frequency and the quantity of alcohol is a problem. So that is
and the reason behind it. The reason behind it is what needs to be addressed. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I mean, it's really lovely talking to you girls. And, hashtag love.
No, thank you so much. Really, really sweet, very innocent, very honest interview. I really loved it. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Bye.